I'm Adrienne Waller. I'm the worldwide educator. I am a Black woman who's in educational leadership and supporting educators who want to envision their dreams of working abroad and moving into leadership. So, of course, I've lived in the United States. That's where I'm from. Michigan, go blue. I then, at the age of 5, I lived in Germany. When I was in college, I did research and lived in South Africa. And then as an educator, I've lived in Qatar, China, Kuwait, and now the Cayman Islands. So living abroad has just made me a better human being. And I will say I'm a much more patient, empathetic, understanding person than I was back home in the US. I'm able to take time to see things from other people's perspective in ways that I just wasn't before. Professionally, it's been amazing. I've grown in my knowledge of education from being around other educators who are from so many different countries that it's helped me to see other ways education is done. And then it's helped me move from the classroom to leadership. And the more I'm in leadership, the more I know it's a gift that's given to me. And so I relish that. You never would think that losing your job would be something that ends up being a good thing for your career. And I definitely think that setback of working remotely because I'm trapped out of China, then losing my job because I can't get back into China, and then accepting a job I shouldn't have accepted, and then being found by an amazing school. That was just like a gem that I never expected. And in hindsight, had I not done the work to update my resume, I wouldn't be in the position I am now to be an assistant principal in the Cayman Islands. I feel loved on, I feel appreciated, I feel valued. Probably the most I have in my whole education career. When I started to look back at things, I realized it all really started with me losing my job in China. Advice I would give is first, make sure you know yourself. And when I say know yourself, that means know what you want, know who you are, know what you value. And what does that look like in terms of your dreams? Second, now that you know yourself, use that to help do research. But research the school that you're going to. Make sure you understand it, what they're about, what they stand for. Make sure you research the country as a whole, that it's somewhere that you would feel safe, that you feel like you would enjoy, that you're okay with the quality of life that offers. Research what the community is like, and if that's important to you, making sure that you're able to connect with people who are similar to you. And that doesn't mean from your same country, it could be, but it could also mean people who have similar interests as you. And last, like I said, I learned to be patient. Be patient. There's going to be a lot of bumps. There's going to be a lot of things that don't go the way you expect, whether that's in the interviewing process, that's in the contract. You're going to learn that patience is going to be one of your biggest tools that'll help you have a successful journey, transition, and new life. One thing that's been really disappointing in almost all of the international schools I've worked at and my friends have worked at is the fact that their local staff, who are typically Black and brown people, often have very low level jobs and so aren't really seen to be people who can have classroom positions, head of school positions, you know, things like that. So I would love to see a shift in valuing those in the countries where the international schools are located. And with that, also understanding that when you're hiring BIPOC educators, that process may look different than it would for hiring non-BIPOC educators. And what do I mean? That means the ways you form connections and get along and all of that will look very different for people who don't have a shared experience as you. And it doesn't mean they're any less valuable to your organization. Thinking about how you give grace and understanding to individuals who show up differently for you and not only welcome them, but also seek them out in your process of hiring and recruitment. So I have a few travel resources that I think would be really great, specifically resources in terms of like moving and living abroad. Facebook is a great resource because there are some amazing groups on there, including Black Americans living abroad, but that has people from like all types of jobs. Brothers and Sisters Working at International Schools is really great because it has Black folks who are at all types of schools internationally. So the last one is Brothers and Sisters of, and then a lot of countries will have a group. So like when I was in Qatar, I had Brothers and Sisters of Qatar. I know Kuwait, the UAE have them. And then one I think has been really amazing where I've learned quite a bit is Living Life Abroad, my club on Clubhouse. And one thing that's really cool about it is that you can live talk to people. It's not this chat back and forth, and then make connections that are lasting. And we've curated a host of different resources that are available to you. There's just been a great amount of information that's shared from people from so many different walks of life that'll make your transition that much smoother and easier.